Okay, so tonight I've come and have been asked to report on this family who are deciding to camp at the Erez crossing with Gaza because they're living in Ramallah, they have no money, they have all sorts of problems. So they've come here to ask if they can move into the Gaza Strip, which is quite a radical decision. And this is where we are right now. So I've been asked if I'll come and basically take a photo and a short video to show what this family, the desperation of this family, and what they're prepared to do to basically ask for help. I don't know how long we're going to be here before somebody comes to check, but that's where we are right now. We're still inside the territory of Israel, so there isn't a problem here. It's not an illegal act to come here. However, it's quite dramatic. So this is basically 11:30 at night, and we're at the border, the Erez border of the Gaza Strip. For an Israeli to want to do this is quite a dramatic act, and Haim Habibi and his wife Violet and their son here. Basically what Haim's saying in Hebrew is how he feels about what's happened to his family in Israel. He feels very strongly about this. Right now his wife is quite afraid of the situation, understandably, and not sure what's going to happen here, but they are going to camp out, and they've asked me to film in English so that the world can see how desperate this family are in order to basically for 25 years they've caused no end of trouble. They've no house, they've no work. They had four beautiful children. But the welfare broke his family with the police. They finished his children. He fought back, and this is the price he paid for fighting. His children suffered from all sorts of psychiatric problems. His daughter tried to harm herself. As you can see, I've written this story. His son had 10 years of
help.
Nothing he could do. The police, the social services, the
Ramallah.
They wouldn't let them live their life. He's showing pictures of his wife. Basically what they did, his wife, with the police, the beatings that she took. He's here to protest.
אין לנו דמי קיום, אין לנו דיור, אין לנו סיוע מאף אחד, ומדינת ישראל ממשיכה לרדוף אותנו ללא הפסקה.
Without a break, he's just suffered. So he's basically come here. Let me go, let my family go. Let us go and live in Gaza. I'd rather live in Gaza. We can't live in Ramallah anymore. We can't live in Israel, so please can we live in Gaza?
לפי מה שאנחנו דיברנו בדרך, בעצם
נביא לך את המסמכים
אחרי ההתעללות שאתם מספרים שעשו לכם פה. למעשה אתה אומר שכרגע אין לכם שום דרך להתפרנס, להתקיים, שום תמיכה של הממסד, זאת אומרת שום דבר מביטוח לאומי, פשוט כלום, אתם לא מקבלים שום דבר, אין לכם זכויות יותר.
He's basically said, been asked if there's another way.
ביטוח לאומי קיום, רפואה, דיור, זכויות סוציאליות למיניהם, תביעות שהגשנו בבתי משפט, שמה שהם עשו לנו, הבית משפט לא מוכן לברר אותם, הוא אומר, אין כסף, אין משפט.
No family, no money, the courts won't listen, they won't help him.
להעסיק אלפי עובדים, פושעים, שיסקרו פרוטוקולים, החלטות, תזכירים בצורה מזויפת במשך 35 שנה. לזה יש כסף בקופת הציבור לבזבז אותו ולסחוק בילדים, בעמותות, לקבל 17,500, להעביר לעמותת אור שלום, ביטוח לאומי, והדבר החמור גם ביותר, גם ועוד יותר חמור, שפקידות שלא הכרנו מעולם, פסיכיאטרים, שופטים, מי לא, מתייגים אותנו כחולי נפש. על אשתי רושמים, עשו ועדה לבן שלי חן, שאנחנו מעולם לא נפגשנו עם הפקידות האלו, אני ואשתי,
וגם הבן שלי חן. It's the destruction of his family. Violet, his wife, is so scared tonight. What's going to happen to their son? Will the police come? She's very
frightened.
He's crying out for help. And hopefully they'll be able to stay here and just camp for a night or two to make their point. When you squeeze the money and you have nowhere to feed your children in Ramallah, they feel there's just nothing left for them. It's a pretty tragic story. He just wants to live in peace with his family. Please just leave us alone and let us live in peace. Give us somewhere to live. That's basically his comments. His story is on my Facebook page and I wrote it 4 months ago. This will go on for a while.